Malacañang keeping its hands off the case against Senator Laila de Lima. Acting presidential spokesperson Martin Andanar says Malacañang respects the independence of the court handling the senator's case. The palace also expresses its trust the Department of Justice and the National Prosecution Service will perform their mandates in investigating and prosecuting the charges against de Lima. As for the National Union of People's Lawyers, Justice Department officials and the courts should take the retractions on de Lima's alleged drug links into full consideration. It maintains the statements should be given corresponding evidentiary value in her pending cases. NUPL President Edrio Lalia also says those behind what it calls brazen injustice against a senator should be held accountable. The Philippine Justice Department star witness in the pending drug cases against Senator Laila de Lima retracts his accusations against the lawmaker. Rafael Ragos also naming former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre as among those who pressured him to testify against the senator. Mike Navalio reports.
Days after self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa retracted all of his allegations against detained Senator Laila de Lima, another high-profile accuser has recanted his claim that de Lima received 10 million pesos worth of drug payoffs when she was Justice Secretary in 2012. Rafael Ragos, a former National Bureau of Investigation official and former OIC of the Bureau of Corrections, executed an affidavit Saturday belying all his claims against Senator Laila de Lima. Among these claims that he, along with former aide Juvencio Ablen Jr., supposedly delivered two tranches of 5 million pesos each to de Lima's former bodyguard Ronnie Dayan at her house in Parañaque City in November and December 2012. The money was supposedly left in his quarters in Bucor and he received a call from an unidentified caller supposedly ordering him to deliver the money to de Lima. That caller he would later identify as convicted drug lord Peter Ko, while another inmate, Hans Tan, allegedly told him it was de Lima's share in the drug trade. But in his affidavit Saturday, Ragos said none of these statements are true, and he would have ordered an investigation had he received such money. He also echoed what the de Lima camp has been saying all along. Why would a Bucor OIC follow the orders of inmates? Instead, Ragos accused former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre II of pressuring him to testify against de Lima. Aguirre allegedly called for a meeting at a casino hotel in Parañaque to force him to sign an affidavit implicating de Lima. Ragos said he was forced to sign out of fear for his life and his family's safety and because he was implicated in one of the drug cases against de Lima. He was later dropped as one of the accused after he agreed to testify. He was also set free after being detained for 7 months.
Ang taong mismong nag-or sa akin ay si Secretary Aguirre and his companies. Tinabag ako ni Secretary Aguirre again. Sabi sa akin, you have to execute ng napilagit. Alam mo na mangyayari. Knowing na wala na akong kawala, captive ako in that instance, I told him, okay,
Ragos also implicated other DOJ officials, including former DOJ Undersecretary Raymond Mecate, who allegedly pressured him to testify, Deputy Directors Rachel Angeles and Vicente de Guzman, who supposedly made his detention difficult, Prosecutor Lawrence Joseph Taliping, who supposedly advised him to testify well because Malacañang is watching, and his own aide, Ablen. Ablen had accused Ragos of running illegal activities in Bucor, while Ragos accused Ablen of being involved in the illegal drug trade. The testimonies of Ragos and Ablen were instrumental in a Muntinlupa court's decision last year to deny one of de Lima's two demurrers to evidence, essentially a motion to dismiss due to insufficiency of evidence. Lawyer Dino De Leon, de Lima's spokesperson, says Ragos's affidavit is significant not only to the drug case where he testified, but also to the other pending drug case involving other Bucor officials. He says this shows a pattern of well-orchestrated political persecution using the entire machinery of the state. He challenges the Department of Justice to withdraw the cases against de Lima.
Now, the main star witness cited by the honorable court as the main reason why our demurrer to evidence in criminal case 165 was not granted has now recanted. So are they now considering their previous statement that in the case of Kevin Espinosa's recantation, it's not very strong because he's not a witness. Are they now conceding that Finally, they will take a look at the case and they know for a fact that this testimony is making a dent on their case. And will the Department of Justice now do the right thing to reinvestigate the case and hopefully to withdraw the charges against Senator Laila de Lima? And more importantly, to investigate their own ranks who have been involved in this sinister plot and the greatest frame-up in Philippine history against a particular individual. It is important for the Department of Justice to do the right thing.
In response to Ragos's retraction, Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento says they will still have to get a copy of the statement. Last week, the Justice Department downplayed the retraction of self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa, who recanted all his allegations against De Lima. ABS-CBN News is still trying to get the side of Aguirre and the other officials Ragos mentioned in his affidavit. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.